If you live in a city, you expect that water will be there when you turn on the tap. But for people who live in more rural parts of the state, they deal with a unique set of issues related to how they get water into their homes. On the east side of the Sandia Mountains, many families are finding that their wells are producing less water or even going dry. In this month's episode of Our Land, correspondent Laura Paskus looks at what these problems mean for individuals and the rest of the state.
The East Mountain communities are only a 30-minute drive from Albuquerque, but they represent a different way of life. That's what attracted Garrett Petrie to the area 10 years ago.
My wife and I fell in love with New Mexico after visiting and decided that we wanted to live here. When we first moved into the area, being as we're both from the Southwest and we're concerned about water, we did ask a lot of questions. We bought the place with the intention of having a well, being somewhat off the grid. We kept hearing things like the wells really vary out here. You can get a good one, you can get a bad one.
After purchasing their home, they repaired a storage tank on the shared well. But soon after that, it went dry. The well went down 425 feet. People compare the area's geology to Swiss cheese. Well depths vary, but 425 feet is normal. After the well dried, for a while, they paid to have water delivered.
When we first started having water delivered here, at that point, it was $85 for delivery for 1,500 gallons, and that would last perhaps 2 weeks.
Having water delivered is expensive, but connecting to the local water utility also adds up.
The initial cost for a membership on the cooperative, I think, was in about the $5,000 range. From their meter on into our home is 400 feet, and so we had to foot the bill to get that plumbing. That was about another $4,000.
More families are facing these choices in the East Mountains. When a well goes dry, you can pay to have it dug deeper, pay to have water delivered, or pay to hook up to the local water district, the Entrenosa Water and Wastewater Association. That's what Petrie and his wife finally did, and they're still recovering financially from having to pay for the infrastructure from where the water meter ended to their house. The aquifer isn't the only source of water. 60 homes in the East Mountains use spring water.
We're kind of on the lower half of the Sandia Mountains, and Cienega Spring is right next to us. I think of it as a necklace of springs around the Sandias. They tend to sit at a similar elevation due to the geology, and so Cienega Spring is just one of many. This spring has been developed to supply the local community with water to their homes. Basically, the Sandias are a big pile of limestone, and snow that falls higher in the Sandias percolates down through the rock and forms a series of aquifers. And so that water pops out at this spring, but it's the same water that goes on down the mountain to feed the lower aquifer as well.
Bonfantine first became interested in water rights and water law while studying at UNM. She owns a home in the area and is a member of the Spring Water Cooperative. She says it's a statewide issue.
I see mounting concern about water because so many people are being affected. So many people are seeing their friends and neighbors having to dig new wells and getting these huge price tags all of a sudden. When I was shopping for a house up here 15 years ago, I looked at a neighborhood in Placidas that had gorgeous houses, but the wells had all gone dry. And so the property values had plummeted. And there was a whole subdivision, basically, that you had a gorgeous house, but you had a huge price tag and a questionable future for water to supply that home.
In order to measure and predict water supply, including how much longer a well might produce, Philip Rust oversees a voluntary well monitoring program for Bernalillo County. The county has drilled wells to observe activity at different depths.
The geology out here is so complex. It's so complex that you can't generalize. And oftentimes, you really don't know what you're going to encounter until you actually drill. You rely on the expertise of your driller to tell you, oh, we hit water at this depth. And that's what you go by. But here, you know, right here, where we're standing right now, you're talking 400 feet, to the shallowest aquifer. And a lot of these wells are 10, 20, 30, 40 years old. So that's a lot of drawdown in each individual well. And when you drill a well, you drill it till you hit water, and then that's good enough. Well, that was, 20 or 30 years ago. Well, now that's not good enough.
As the climate continues warming, the problem isn't going to go away. And the first step, experts like Rust say, is understanding what's happening and how widespread the problem is.
If nothing else, it's a lesson about good resource management, if nothing else. And unfortunately, in the Sandia Basin, we've got a limited resource and a high demand. And if we don't manage it effectively, then we face the reality of critical loss, not having enough.
This isn't just an issue in the East Mountains. Wells are going dry across the Sandia Basin, from Placitas to Tejeras. A recent study by scientists at the University of California, Santa Barbara, and Stanford University looked at more than 2 million groundwater wells across 17 western states. These were drilled from the 1950s until recently, and they found that 1 in 30 wells were dry in 2013 through 2015. For New Mexico in Focus and Our Land, I'm Laura Paskus.